In a previous video, we have talked about dimensions and units. As far as units are concerned, we have seen that there are two primary systems of units out there, USCS system, also known as English system, as well as SI system or metric unit system. Now, units are important to write properly from a communication point of view, whether it's oral or whether it's written. You may have heard about this true story of Mars Climate Orbiter, $125 million mission that was lost because of the mismatch of the units between engineering team of Lockheed Martin and the engineering team at NASA. So apparently Lockheed Martin team was using English system for communicating the thrust of the thruster, while NASA assumed that it was actually in the metric system. So a huge mission was lost because of that. So it's important for us to learn how to write the units in the right way. So I'm going to give you an example, and I'm just going to create an example over here of maybe a project report that a team of students in engineering write. And let's say this is a robot design project. So let's say the team writes, we have designed a walking robot that can walk at a speed of 4 meters per second. Okay, so this is one of the facts, let's say the team writes. They also add that it weighs 10 kilograms and can turn at 3 RPM. So by RPM, they probably mean revolution per minute. The robot is powered by 2 DC motors, each providing a torque of 10 newtons meters. It can travel for a distance of 3 feet before coming to a stop. So, this is a fictitious report that I just created. And what we want to understand is if this report is written in the proper way from the unit's perspective. Okay, so we're not talking about the English language, but mostly from the unit perspective. And many of you have probably already noticed several mistakes that are apparent in this short report. So you might say that, hey, there's something wrong with how meters per second is written. So the question is, how should we write it? Can we write meter per second? Can we write meters per second? Should this M should be uppercase? Whether this should be plural or not? It weighs 10 kilogram. Something seems to be wrong with that as well. Because we know the kilogram is a unit of mass, not exactly weight. Weight is a force. It can turn at 3 RPM. The question is this a standard way of writing RPM, or should we have to write revolutions per minute in full? The robot is powered by 2 DC motors. Question of English, this 2 should really be written as TWO, each providing a torque of 10 newton meters. So again, several questions arise over here, whether this N should be uppercase or not, whether we should have a, pluralizing S or not, this should be uppercase or not, and same thing with this pluralizing S. So it can travel for a distance of 3 feet. Well, can we write the feet like that? Should we add a dot after it or not, right? So there are several questions over here. And for us to be able to communicate in the right way, we have to know exactly how to write the units. Okay, so there are certain rules for how the units should be written. So I'm going to just write down all those rules. So rules. Okay, and this is not going to be exhaustive, but most of the rules. So one is that with the exception of Kelvin, which as you know is the unit of temperature, unit names after individuals are not capitalized when written in full. Okay, so with the exception of Kelvin, all the unit names after individuals are not to be capitalized when written in full. So for example, if you want to write Newton, you have to write N-E-W-T-O-N like that, or you can write uppercase L if you're going to abbreviate it. Joule has to be written like this. If you abbreviate it, then you can write uppercase J. Pascal can be written as uppercase P and then lowercase a. Watt can be written as this, which means that it would be wrong to say that there is a torque of 10 Newton meter in the previous example by making N to be uppercase. So if you want to write that, then you have to say 10 Newtons, okay? Or you can say 10 N, that would be. And then you don't add S after it to make it plural, because that might be seen as Newton's second. So that would be all. So simply 10 N would be enough. Exception is Kelvin. So Kelvin can be written in uppercase. Don't ask me why. Number two is, you do not use prefix for numerical values between 0.1 and 1000. You can use prefix otherwise. Okay, so for example, you would write 1 megawatt. So uppercase M over here, it stands for mega, which is 10 power 6, instead of saying 1,000, 1,000, and then another 3 zeros, watt. Okay, so if the values are between 0.1 and 1,000, then you don't use prefixes, but if the values are smaller than 0.1 or more than 1,000, then you use a prefix. So another rule is, for fractional quantities, you apply prefix to the numerator. Okay, you apply prefix to the numerator. So example, you would write, let's say 5 kilonewton per meter. Okay, so the idea is you're trying to write 5,000 newton per meter instead of 5 newton per millimeter. So numerically speaking, both of them will give you the same thing, because this is equal to 5 × 10³ newton per meter. Okay, per meter, and this would be equal to also 5 × 10³, because this is millimeter, so you convert that into 10⁻³ meters, so that will be newton per meter. Okay, but the rule is that you apply prefix to the numerator, not to the denominator. Okay, so that's the rule. All right, another rule is, do not write units in plural form when abbreviating. So when you write them in the abbreviated form or the short form, then you don't pluralize them. Okay, so for example, 5 kilogram S to indicate that you're writing kilograms would be wrong. So this would be wrong. Instead, you would simply say 5 kilogram. You will not pluralize it. Now, if you really want to pluralize it, then you can write 5 kilograms when you're not pluralizing it. So if you write it in full, you can write kilograms. That would be fine. More rules. Dimensions in SI units are written in lowercase So the exception are the units named after individuals. So exception are units named after individuals. Okay, so more examples. You would write 5 kilogram, where this k is lowercase, not 5k, where this k is uppercase. So that would be wrong. This would be wrong. You would write 2 meters, but not 2 meters, where this is uppercase. So this would be wrong as well. Okay. The last rule is to not use mathematical operations on unit names. So again, example, you can write joule per kilogram. Okay, these are the complete unit names we're writing, we're not abbreviating them. So instead of using a mathematical operation where we are trying to divide something, we write per. Or you can write joule per kilogram. So now you can apply, this is a mathematical operation, you can apply this slash over here because you have abbreviated it. Another way to write this would be joule times kilogram to the power minus 1. That will be fine. But what you cannot do, not joule per kilogram. That would be wrong because you have applied a mathematical operation slash over here on the unit names. Okay. So these are some basic rules that you have to keep in mind. And if you keep these rules in mind, most of the time you will be able to write the unit names properly and will come across as learned engineer. Now let's look at some examples. So let's say we write 5 sec. Is that right? 5 sec? Well, sec is not an accepted abbreviation of second. So either you would fix this by writing 5s or by saying 5 seconds. Okay. What about 2cc to indicate you are trying to measure something in volume, in cubic centimeter? That is also not an accepted way of abbreviating cubic centimeter. So either you write 2 centimeter cube or you write 2 cubic centimeters in full. Okay. How about 5 miles per hour? So you're trying to write miles per hour, so you write 5 mph, which is very common. You see people writing miles per hour like that. That's also not accepted. So you either write 5 miles per hour using the full names of the units, or you write 5 miles per hour, which would also be okay because these are accepted abbreviations. So you just have to know what are the accepted abbreviations and you'll be fine. And one of the ways to learn this is when you pick up your textbook, whether it's Mech 101 book or 262 book or any other book, you look at how the units have been written in the textbook and learn from that. Another set of examples. Somebody writes length equal to 75 centimeters. Okay, so somebody's trying to pluralize this, so they write CMS. The unfortunate part is that this could be easily read as centimeter times second. So instead of saying that, you would fix this by simply saying 75 centimeter, or you can write centimeters in full. So centimeters, that would be fine. Another one, the bar, some bar is 75 centimeter long. Somebody writes a sentence. What's wrong with this? It doesn't look like there's anything wrong, except that there is this extra dot over here, which is completely unnecessary. So you would get rid of that. So you'd say the bar is 75 centimeter, no dot, long. Or you can rephrase it by saying the length of the bar is 75 centimeter. Then you don't have that issue whatsoever. Okay. Somebody writes 2 kilogram per meter cube. Okay. Or writes, let's say, kilogram per cubic meter. And both of them are wrong, clearly, because you have applied a mathematical operation on unit names and you're mixing the unit names with the abbreviated form. Same thing over here, no mathematical operation is allowed on the unit names because you've written cubic meter over here. So the right way to do this would be to write 2 kilogram per meter cube, or you write in full 2 kilogram per cubic meter or in words. So let's look at one last. How about 5 newtons or 5 newtons like that? Well, both of them are wrong. Why? Because you're writing in full, so this should not be uppercase, so that should be lowercase. So this would be corrected by writing 5 newtons, and this would be corrected by writing simply 5N. No S, because this S over here might indicate that that's a second. So based on all these rules, now you can probably go back and fix this report over here. Okay, and I'll leave that as an exercise for you to do.